Okey-doke. Good evening, everyone. Today is June 14th, 2011, Tuesday night. Hello, everyone. This is Kat from YokosoNews, YokosoNews.com. YokosoNews is the online website to introduce Japan in English so that you can understand Japanese culture more. However, since the March 11th earthquake and tsunami and Fukushima nuclear incident, I've been broadcasting on disaster update on every Tuesday night. So this is the 40th day, 40th time. Today is the number 40th of the 311 disaster update since the March 11th. So yeah.
Music by Kevin MacLeod.
All right, so today we, as usual, kinda, we have Borden on Skype. Hey, what's up, Borden?
Hello, everyone.
So, what's up with you, Borden, last week? I mean, within this week.
Since Dr. Shinzaku?
Oh, yeah.
The past 2 days, well, I went to work, and then I went to work again.
nothing really changed in the but you're about, did you move to Tokyo?
No, 11 more days.
Okay, 11 more days.
I got to tell everyone, all my fellow ALTs yesterday, that I'm quitting.
Oh, okay. Okay, cool. So everyone, Yokoso News usually bring the fun information about Japanese culture, like Dr. Shinzaku, that he also joined last Sunday. You can still watch the archive at the YokosoNews.com. And yeah, so we usually bring those stuff. But actually, bringing the disaster information is actually YokosoNews primary core mission since the launch of the YokosoNews, because I wanted to dedicate this broadcast to two kinds of people: the people who live in Japan and cannot really speak English much.
Because, you mean Japanese?
Japanese much? Yes. Thank you, Borden. Yes, in Japanese much, because we provide the latest information in Japanese first. Then second kind of people I wanted to dedicate this broadcast is the people who have a direct relationship to Japan. But mainly I wanted to because Japan is Japan is full of natural disaster. Well, that's why we have a great nature in Japan, but that's, we have a hot spring because we have volcano, and because we have a volcano, beautiful mountain, that's why, we have volcano, we have earthquake and everything. So we have to live in order to benefit from the natural disaster. We had to live with the disaster, so it is really, I've been wanting to provide enough disaster prevention information from YokosoNews. So this is no question that I've started a disaster update broadcast on 6 minutes after the earthquake, and I was broadcasting almost every day, and now I'm still committed to broadcast weekly to give you this information from Yokkaichi, Japan. So hello, up and goable Sam and Annette, good evening from Japan. So today, last couple times since we switched from the daily to weekly, we tend to have more guests coming in, but today I'm taking a break because I have other project got really kicked in that I kind of busy. But but today I have so many small bad news. So I just wanted to share with you these small bad news. But what those small many bad news are? First, tsunami related stuff. As I expected from the experience that we had during the 1995 Great Hanshin earthquake, mentally the victim of the tsunami and earthquake start having really hard time after, like, as the situation getting longer. So that's the first update. Second up, it's going to be a Fukushima nuclear power plant update. We actually have the breaking news that across the 16 prefectures of Japan, from the sewage system, they start finding the highly contaminated radioactive soil from the sewage system. How do you say those processing facility of the sewage system, Borden?
The processing facility, the sewage treatment facility?
Yeah, something like that. So you know, because of the, as you remember, the radiation trouble all over Japan, and all in the, some of it reached to the United States and stuff too. But those small radiation got washed away by the rain and went into the sewage system, and then the mud of the sewage system got accumulated and start having the highly contamination. So that now throughout Japan, we start finding those highly contaminated mud from the sewage processing facility. That's today's breaking news from the NHK. And then we Japanese government, local governments needs to kind of have to take care of those mud. So that's today's latest news. And second news is that strontium, did I pronounce correct?
Yes.
Okay, strontium. They keep finding strontium all over, like, all over from on site of the Fukushima nuclear power plant and offshore, like 20 kilometers offshore of the ocean, strontium. So the ocean contamination of the strontium is getting bad. And third main bad news is the severe working condition of the TEPCO worker and contracting workers on site of the Fukushima, because we start finding more TEPCO or TEPCO contracting workers are exposed to high amount of the radiation. But we kind of do have a good news that finally, they start working on the contaminated water processing system on site of the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant. They just finished testing the system, and they were able to process some of the contaminated water. So it's kind of working. Then, you know, we have other bad news, small kind of bad news, like, no, it's not small. We have some of the green tea of the some area, they found high amount of the contamination of the cesium. And then, and stuff. And yeah, so we have so many bad news that you know, all these news were used to be like breaking news, but now it's like one of the small news. Those are the main topic of today, but I just gonna move slowly and give you these in-depth report of what we just talked about. All right, so what is strontium up in Goebo?
Strontium.
What's strontium? It's the one type of the radiation, and then radioactive. But I'm not the scientist, but it has the similar type to the calcium. So these type of the radiation is easy to absorb onto your bones and stays into your bones, so it could cause the bone-related cancer. So that's why you don't want to get the strontium contamination. That's why it's kind of big deal. But yet, it is only high amount are yet found on site of the Fukushima Daiichi, and some area were found outside of 20 kilometer zone of the ocean. Yet, right now, according to Ministry of Education, which is monitoring the radioactive contaminated water level of the ocean, it shouldn't be that much. Let's go from the today's update, huh? So I went to I just want to start off with my latest, my own coverage of the day. Last Saturday night, last Saturday was June 11th, which was the 3 month anniversary since the March 11th. So various group of the anti-nuclear or organization tried to organize 1 million people's demonstration across the Japan. So, okay, they're talking and they are happening in Nagoya too. And I happened to be in Nagoya. So I just wanted to check out that how Japanese people are doing to try to work on this. So I have the footage right now. So I actually was tweet casting, so some of you might remember. But so I went to the center of Nagoya, Japan, which is called Sakae, and first they were doing this. Had some tent and had a music show. So, Borden, does this look like 1 million people?
Looks like 20.
Yeah.
Well, to be fair, the 1 million was supposed to be in the whole country.
Yeah.
But still, you need more than this
to be able to, get the 1 million total nationwide people. Yeah, there were about 200-300 people, I think. So they were doing some kind of gathering in Nagoya. And they were some singing some song and try to appeal it to the people, these were the event.
Hey, there's more people now.
Yeah, it's getting, yeah, it's getting, yeah. But that, you know, when I pan back, no, but it's completely empty. Empty.
But how many of these people are here because
of this?
Because of the event, and how many are just here because they saw something?
And they're just passing by.
Yeah, if I walk through Waynell Park and I see something like this, I'll stop and be like, hey.
Yeah, so.
Oh, right, Waynell Park, your park, right?
Yeah, my park, yes. My last name is Ueno, by the way. So you know, they did some, so they finished some talk and concert stuff, and they start lining up, and they are going to go to the street demonstration. And check this out. I think the number of the police officer may be more than attendees.
Ooh. What are the police doing?
Well, try guard these demonstrators, and then...
Did anyone try to attack?
No. No, it was really peaceful, but...
It doesn't seem like the kind of event that somebody would get angry at.
No, but no, there were some... Because police did escort these demonstrators and stop traffic and stuff. So there were some angry car drivers.
Angry drivers? Well, what did they say? Well, we want nuclear power! Blah!
No, but... So police were escorting like this, and there were some police videotaping the attendees too.
Yeah, well, I know how it works. I was in a protest when I was 17 against the Iraq war, and we got a lot of lewd gestures and yelling things from cars passing by.
No, that was police videotaping the demonstrator right now.
And, evidence.
Yeah. Then then moving on to the next. I stayed.
Oh, you got the cute couple back there.
Okay, everyone. Since I are doing talk show.
Then, so I got bored, so I was promoting Dr. Shinsaku's show when I was doing Tweetcast.
YokosoNews. The Skype ID is YokosoNews. And then you will be able to.
Really? What did you say? This event sucks. Watch Dr. Shinsaku.
Pretty much.
Anyway.
Switzerland and Germany, they have so many people attend to the anti-nuclear, event to give out the voice. And I know that when I talk to many Japanese people, they want to express their, thought. But Japanese people are shy, so they didn't want to come out.
Newspaper guy.
Oh, so the only one news mainstream media. I saw only one mainstream new media covering right next to me.
Only one Japanese mainstream media is.
Well, don't feel that bad. A lot of in America or Western countries, there's a lot of posturing also for elections or just to look good for the moment.
Yeah, but it wasn't long either, it's only like, it was short line of the, I went to Iraq, anti-Iraq war demonstration in LA, so I saw how people protest, so compared to that, this is okay.
I think if Japan went to war, there would be a bigger protest.
Yeah, maybe. So that's pretty much it from the report of the the report of the anti-nuclear event from 6/11. So from that, of course, I only saw the one in Nagoya. Again, there are more people in Tokyo, there are more people in Hokkaido, thanks to Nethead, who are watching the my tweetcast live, and they were broadcasting all over Japan using the Ustream to broadcast the nationwide event. There are, you know, I think they had about total like 100,000 people attendees nationwide, but far less than 1 million attendees. So that's kind of, you know, kind of that could conclude that Japanese people are not that anti-nuclear overall. Can I say that?
You can say whatever you like.
yeah. So
you just have to beware of the responses that you might get.
Yeah, but I mean, that's how actually, you know, Japanese people are right now. But because I'm Japanese and I talk to some other people, so I talked to a couple people like in Nagoya. Oh, you didn't go to the demonstration? No, I had to go to other meeting. Okay, so anti-nuclear is less important than having fun on the weekend. So okay.
Oh, don't say meeting then. It sounds like business.
No. It was kind of a study group and about IT design and stuff that I went. Up in Guebo, 100,000 still be considered an impressive number. I think it's more cultural with, actually could be 10,000 overall. It could be less than 100,000 overall. Because, no. Yeah.
What does the internet say?
Internet says all over. It could be, I don't think it's 100,000. I wasn't, after I saw the Nagoya anti-nuclear demonstration stuff, that only 300 people, like I didn't bother to check the number because I know it wouldn't be as much as 1 million and it wouldn't be, you know, that much. So, yep. You know, yeah. All right, anyway, so that was my original coverage of the YokosoNews. Something that I had to bring, original coverage of the week. But actually, you know, by doing this, I think Japanese people should express their mind more to the public as you know, whether they are anti-nuclear or they are pro-nuclear. They Japanese people have been taught to be quiet. So yeah.
It's awful in school. You ask a question, nobody wants to answer unless they're 100%, 110% sure that it's correct.
Yeah.
And even if they're sure, they still look to the side and make sure that their friends agree with them first.
Yes, but that's how our Japanese education system is. And yeah, but you know, anyway, I just going to say that Japanese protesters were disappointing. This is my personal opinion. But by saying this, I hope that more Japanese people are going to speak out, whether they're anti-nuclear or pro-nuclear. right now that no one is speaking now. No, so many Japanese people are speaking now because they don't want to be responsible of what they say. They only want politician and then TEPCO to be responsible at this moment. So that's, it's, you know, by doing this, it is TEPCO's fault. It is, you know, it could be partially TEPCO's fault. It could be partially, you know, it is obviously partially Japanese government fault, but also this is also how Japanese people didn't want to be responsible of what their action is too. That's my personal opinion. Then, yeah. All right, cool. But I'm not going to say I'm going to support anti-nuclear demonstration because I'm not 100% anti-nuclear. So.
Me neither.
Yeah. To be honest, I'm not really 100% against. So that's the original news of the day. So let's going back to the weekly update of this week. We have so much news this week. So again, I said that today's breaking news is that according to NHK, its own investigation, NHK found out that at least 16 prefectures, they did investigate radioactive contamination of their sewage system, and then they found 16 prefectures found the radioactive contamination from the mud from the sewage system facility. The most number of the contamination was found from Fukushima City, which is about 447,000 becquerel per kilogram. Next is Tokyo, 55,000 becquerel per kilogram. Third is Maebashi, Ibaraki.
Maebashi is in Ibaraki?
Yeah. Tochigi?
I thought it was Gunma.
Oh, yeah, it doesn't say which prefecture. Sorry. Maebashi, Gunma.
Yeah, it's in Gunma.
Thank you. I'm so glad that I have someone who live in near Gunma.
Yep. Just a few stops away.
Yeah. Thank you. Maebashi is 42,800 becquerel. And Utsunomiya, it was 26,000 becquerel per kilogram.
Tochigi.
Yeah, Tochigi. It is, you know, it's amazing that Tokyo was the second place that they found highly contaminated radioactive mud from the sewage system. Again, I think this is because of the how many people live in Tokyo and how much water were used in Tokyo. And so that their sewage system, they process more low amount, more water. So these mud, as you know, it's just even though water itself has a very low radioactive contamination that wouldn't really risk the health, but if you piling up in the mud, then it gets more contaminated. So according to various local government officials, according to NHK, these are highly contaminated mud are just, it's only found in the sewage system, not like all over Tokyo, just a part, just at the sewage system. But it is the huge concern now that how they're going to take care of these highly contaminated, highly radioactive contaminated soil. According to NHK, they report the some civil organization who did test the radioactive level around the sewage processing facility, and they were about four times as much as the average Tokyo radiation level. So I think because it is just a breaking news from NHK just now, so I just turn in and then didn't have the exact location, but one of the, I think it was either Itabashi or I'm not going to mention, but one of the one around this one civil rights group did the test of the surrounding environmental radiation level metering, and usually in Tokyo they only find about 0.06 or 7 microsievert power, but around that sewage processing facility they found about 0.24 microsievert power, although it is still low level, but still four times as much as the rest of the Tokyo. So the people in Tokyo, especially those who live around the sewage processing facility, are worried about the health risk. And
at that rate, it'll double your natural exposure in a year.
Yeah. So according to NHK, the prefecture that they found the radioactive contamination of the soil from the sewage processing facilities are Hokkaido, Aomori, Yamagata, Fukushima, Tochigi, Gunma, Ibaraki, Chiba, Saitama, Tokyo, Kanagawa, Yamanashi, Niigata, Nagano, Shizuoka, and Osaka. So these 16, from 16 sewage processing facility of these prefecture, they found the radioactive contaminated mud from the sewage processing facility.
Did you say Osaka?
Yes.
That's very strange, very random.
Yeah, but again, they only 22 prefecture out of 47 conducted this research, and 16 out of 22 found it. So I don't know the rest of the 25 are. And then also this is the sewage processing facility.
Mm.
So, you know, so
Saitama's webpage has the results of their investigation into the sewage, all the sewage centers, all five of them.
Mm.
Cool. It's not, I don't know when the other ones were taken. It says this one was from May 27th.
Mm.
But it has two categories. It has regular mud, regular dirty mud, and incinerated, dried, dirty mud.
Mm.
And the incinerated, dried, dirty mud is much, much higher.
Because
it's concentrated.
Yeah. So I think these high amount are those highly concentrated mud or something. Anyway, so according to NHK, these prefecture local governments are trying to burn this mud to make it smaller amount, and they are trying to preserve it at the safe area until further notice from the Japanese government. But, you know, so it is not urgent in a way, but because it is just, I could say just around the sewage processing facility, but as we use the water as we have to process more the sewage water, you know, there would be will be more mud, more it could be more highly contaminated mud too, but it depends on the how much radiation it's going to spread all over Japan, but more. But you know, it's according to NHK, every year we are getting about 2.2 million tons of these sewage mud that we have to process. So we now have to, if you know, of course all of them are not going to be, may not be going to be a radioactive contaminated, but you know, we never thought that sewage system mud is going to be radioactive contaminated, so we have no plan whatsoever what to do with this sewage system mud. So that's the environmental stuff, and also surrounded the environment surrounding of the sewage system may, you know, bleed more radiation. So that's although it is kind of low, but amount yet, but you know, it is the concern of the neighbors of the sewage system too. So immediate action is needed according, you know, so that's, so today's news, according to NHK, TEPCO did conduct the test to start running the water filtering system to remove the cesium from the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant. So they are working, they did the test, and as they did the test run, the they were able to remove some of many cesium. They were able to reduce the cesium 134 to 29 thousands, and cesium 137 reduced to 33 thousands of like 0.0003% or zero, you know, like 99.99 some percent of the cesium they were able to remove from this highly contaminated water. So according to TEPCO, so they are planning to fully start fully functioning water filtering system at the Fukushima Daiichi on June 17th, so that hopefully they can reduce the amount of the ocean contamination from the Fukushima Daiichi. As of today at 6 p.m., according to the police department, about 15,429 people are confirmed dead, and 7,781 people are still missing. The total of the deaths and missing are 23,210 as of 6 p.m. on June 14th, according to NHK. Again, according to NHK and according to the police department, there are about 83,951 people are still in the shelter. So, according to Ministry of Education, as on June 14th, most of the area radiation level are unchanged.
23,000 people is about 11 times the population of the town I grew up in.
Yep. Okay. So Fukushima, today's radiation level, Fukushima City, was 1.39 microsievert. Koriyama, Fukushima, was 1.29 microsievert. Shirakawa, Fukushima, was 0.55 microsievert. Minami Soma, Fukushima was 0.5 microsievert. Iwaki, Fukushima was 0.24 microsievert. And Sendai, Miyagi was 0.076 microsievert. Kita Ibaraki, Ibaraki was 0.211 microsievert. Mito, Ibaraki was 0.106 microsievert. Tochigi, in Utsunomiya, Tochigi, it was 0.073 microsievert. Kawasaki, Kanagawa was 0.069 microsievert. Ichihara, Chiba, it was 0.045 microsievert. These are the location which was slightly or little bit higher than regular radiation level. But these are the only places that were higher than other places besides 20 kilometer zone. And then rest of the Japan had average radiation rating according to a Ministry of Education who supervised monitoring the radiation level.
Saitama City 0.052.
Which is normal. Normal?
Yeah, okay. Yes. Normal is below 0.06.
Okay. Actually, before we go in, we actually had heavy rain last weekend. And in Kumamoto, Kyushu, 70,000 people, they ordered evacuation call to 70,000 people in Kumamoto, Kyushu. So they had actually heavy rain last weekend. So tendency. So in addition to the to North Japan, tendency. Well, again, Japan is in the rainy season. It start getting clear up, but during the tendency of this rainy season is it doesn't rain that much, but when it rains a lot. So that's the tendency.
It pours.
Yeah, it pours. Yeah.
It's ridiculous.
No. Well, it's Mother Nature.
Mother Nature has a bad attitude this time of year.
Okay.
But it's good for the rice.
Yep. Okay, so that's... Now I'm going into the update of the tsunami and earthquake. Then I will come back to Fukushima nuclear power plant update from now. So now, the main topic of the Fukushima nuclear power... The main topic of the tsunami and earthquake disaster victims are more getting to the mental states of the victim. So, for example, I saw the news that, oh my god, I can't find it. I bookmark so much news. Oh, I have this. I can read this news that about the number of the people who apply for the food stamp has exceeded 2 million in Japan. So as of this March, the number of the people who are on the food stamp were 2,022,333 people. So this is the record number high since 1952. So this is probably because of the tsunami and earthquake, but too. So now it is getting to the point where the victim is no longer victim of tsunami and earthquake, but the homeless. So I've heard the story from the Great Hanshin Earthquake in 1995 that as we fade away, as we lose the attention to those people in North Japan, those people in North Japan will simply become homeless from the victim, jobless, homeless people. So now what we need is that it's not just we still kind of need to send them money, but it's actually another problem is that the scale of the disaster is so huge that many people are still haven't received the donation from the people yet because of the lack of the human resources to distribute the donation. But donation will reach this victim eventually. However, because of the scale and lack of the resources, many city clerks also were killed by the disaster as well. And they had to build temporary housing and stuff too. So overwhelmed, they're all overwhelmed. So donation money has been reached and stuff. So. And we also have the news according to NHK as on June 14th. About 100 million yen, about 1.2 million US dollars got stolen from the ATM machine in North Japan. So
it wasn't me.
And then we also have the other news that yeah. Well, I mean, I'm just gonna read, but two. So the mental stage of the victim or the mental care of the victim are critical. Then today's news, according to NHK and Yomiuri. 50 farmers animal farmers, is that animal farmers?
Ranchers?
ranchers in the 50s from Soma, Fukushima, commit suicide on June 11th. He was taking care of the cow to produce the milk. However, his milk was suspended from the shipping, and he had to throw away the milk every day. He started getting depressed. He had a Filipina wife and kids, but his wife and kids went back to Philippines, and he was alone. And then, according to NHK's interview, his acquaintances, that probably he was depressed and didn't foresee the future. And probably he was having hard time in terms of the financially, and he committed suicide. Let's go to the food safety first. So according to Yomiuri, they are, so they found some amount of the cesium from the one of the factory of the Shizuoka prefecture now. So that it's like a political debate and whether they want to check the radiation of all that and that and that. Yeah. So on the June 9th, they found about 670 becquerel of the cesium from the Shizuoka Honyamacha, from the Honyamacha's tea in Shizuoka. So the radioactive contamination of the tea has reached to one district of the Shizuoka. They haven't found the high amount of the cesium in the other area. They did find some amount of the cesium from the other area, but it didn't exceed the 500 becquerel per kilogram, which Japanese government said that it's the limit. So now the green tea farmers are demanding the damage pay, and Edano-san, cabinet chief secretary Edano-san, said that Japanese government will cover the damage for the tea farmers as well. And the fish of the Iwaki Fukushima, offshore of the Iwaki Fukushima, Ainame and Ezoi no Ainame, I don't know in English, but these kinds of two fish, they found more than 500 becquerel per kilogram of the cesium from Ainame, Ezoi so Ainame, and Kitamura Sakiuni from the Iwaki Fukushima. So that has been the food safety update. So now going to the kind of the regular tsunami and disaster update. So again, I said that June 11th were the third month anniversary of the tsunami and earthquake. So for example, Minami Sanriku, Miyagi, they conducted a mass funeral. Then Minami Sanriku, the town invited the family of the missing to the funeral too. So by inviting the family of the missing to this mass funeral, Minami Sanriku are kind of advising to tell these family member to give up the hope. Yeah. So on June 13th, in Miyagi Prefecture, they are going to simplify the process of applying the death certificate to those who's missing. Usually, in the Japanese law, if people went missing, people has to be missed for over a year to be recognized dead legally. But because of the amount of the damage, and some people need to claim a health life insurance, so these Japanese government are now allowing to turn in the death certificate application after 3 months. So it was after 3 months on June 11th. So in Miyagi, according to NHK Yomiuri, many people came to the city office to turn in the death certificate application for their missing families. So it you know, NHK was also showing some document, you know, some report that you know, it is really hard to admit, you know, it's just a simple piece of paper that they just turn in, but by turning in the just a simple piece of paper, that kind of showing that to recognize that his or her family are dead, but they kind of need to turn this in order to claim the life insurance. Without the life, because they don't have money, they need some money to start the new life. So NHK was showing the some of the hardship of these families as well. According to NHK, on June 14th at 5 a.m. in Fukushima Prefecture, about 160 babies and infants are still spending their life in the shelters. So even still 160 infants and babies are in the shelter. Only one shelter provide the preschool, like nursing care service. So especially in Fukushima, those nursing care service of the baby and the infants are needed. So yes. And we have one heartwarming news from NHK. Today, from Kesennuma, Miyagi, they found one surviving oyster from their oyster plant in the Kesennuma Bay. So they had to throw away 3 tons of the oyster that they were growing in the plant, but one fisherman found one alive oyster, and it was energizing news that one oyster was able to survive. On June 13th, according to NHK, in Nagasaki, they appointed the new peace ambassador, high school peace ambassador, yesterday on June 13th. Every year in Nagasaki Prefecture, they appointed a 11 peace ambassador to claim the to stop the nuclear weapon thingy, you know. But this year they chose 2 high school students from Rikuzen Takada Iwate, so that in addition to appeal to peace, but they're hoping to also share the knowledge and experience of the disaster to the world. And not only a North Japan, but Nagano, they had seismic scale 6 plus huge earthquake on March 12th. So June 12th, a day after the big earthquake. It was also 3 months anniversary of the magnitude 6 earthquake of Nagano, which they had huge damage. About 700 houses got damaged, and still 121 people are still, spending their life in the shelter. So on June 12th in Nagano, they had some event to cheer these people up as well. So not only North Japan, there are people in the and Nagano having a hard time too. So according to NHK, so the next news, according to NHK and also other like Yomiuri stuff too, they are going to finish 1,000 yen expressway price cap on the weekends. So since like, when was it, 2009? Was it 2009, Borden?
What was what, 2009?
Like 1,000 yen expressway cap. Do you know about that?
I came to Japan in late 2009.
Oh, okay. Okay. So anyway, on the weekend, the regular car could go anywhere under 1,000 yen.
Usually, oh, actually, I did hear about that.
Yeah. So, but they're going to stop this service campaign on June 19th.
Oh.
Because they need more money.
Well, yeah, I guess so.
Relief aid. So, 1,000 yen expressway price cap is going to end on June 19th. So, if you want to travel, you might want to do it by this weekend. But I guess this weekend it's going to be jammed, heavy, super jam for those travelers who wants to enjoy the benefit of the 1,000 yen expressway. So people do expect a high traffic jam this weekend.
Take the train.
Yeah. But for the full members, family and stuff, you know, car is much cheaper than taking a ride on the train, you know.
For now. Yeah.
So according to I'm coming back to this news, according to NHK, in Fukushima prefecture, according to the police in the Fukushima prefecture, in and around Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant, they had 23 of their ATM machine's money got stolen. The total of 100 million yen, more than 100 million yen of the cash from ATM machine were stolen from Fukushima area. So again, there are some Japanese thief who try to take advantage of this situation, still, you know, hurting people. So on June 7th, and also this is according to Yomiuri, but also NHK and many WBS, all the major media sources are talking about this. So many small business owner wants to resume their work, but in order to resume their work, they need to also have the loan. They need to make an additional loan, but many of them haven't finished paying back the previous loan. So the issue of the small business owner in order to resume their work is how to take care of the double loan that they will have to face. And last, according to Yomiuri and also NHK and all major Japanese media are talking about super coalition between the LDP and DPJ. But, you know, I'm going to skip the political talk this week because we have much more other news to talk about. FRBs from the Bernanke's, FRBs. Bernanke, what's his title?
Treasury Secretary.
Yeah, Treasury Secretary Bernanke said that the effect of the this tsunami and an earthquake would come to affect to the economy of the U.S. on June 8th, which is kind of old news. According to the World Bank, on June 7th, Japan's economy's growth is going to be 0%.
Oops, I was wrong. He's the chairman of the Federal Reserve.
Yeah, chairman of Federal Reserve, sorry. Yeah, I know in Japanese, but sometimes, because I'm reading Japanese news and I just don't get the correct.
You're doing better than me.
Correct English English title.
You know, I didn't even know it in English.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Then, you know, we have the news of the illustrate, you know, all kinds of people who's volunteering. North Japan are still. So then, on June 8th, the parliament and how the parliament and upper house passed the special bill to make an exception to postpone the analog broadcasting. So rest of Japan, actually all of Japan, we were supposed to finish analog broadcasting of
next
TV.
Next month.
Right. Yeah. However, in Iwate, Miyagi, Fukushima, because of the degree of the disaster, they don't have time to upgrade their facility. They have to fix the facility too, but they don't have time to install the new digital like equipment. So they passed the exception bill. They passed a special bill to give the exception to the people of Iwate, Miyagi, Fukushima to postpone the switch, complete switch from analog to digital on July 24th for about 1 year. And on June 8th, according to Ministry of Land, because they're going to finish 1,000 yen weekend cap and everything, but according to Ministry of Land, as long as you have a certificate of the disaster, it's called Risai Shome, if you have that certificate of the Risai Shome or Hisai Shome, which is the certificate of the disaster victim or something. I don't know the correct English title. If you have the certificate issued by your local government, you will be able to take a expressway for free in the Tohoku and expressway, Joban, Joetsu expressway, about 20 expressway of Japan. You will be able to go through the expressway, 20 street of the expressway for free. So, or if you are living in the warning zone or evacuation zone of Fukushima Daiichi, all you have to have is a driver license. Then you will be able to ride the freeway for free. And this is another bad guys news. According to Yomiuri, on June 8th, Ishinomaki Police Department arrested two guys, one 53 years old guy and 50 years old guy, were arrested from the perjury. Yeah. So these two guys collect the bank card from on the street, swapped away by tsunami, and they withdrew the money to pretend to be the owner of the bank card. So it is kind of I kind of have to explain the culture of the Japanese banking. You have to get the bank book. Then if you have a bank book, we don't have a bank like statement, but the bank book and stuff. But anyway, so these two guys took advantage of that, and they stole the money. They withdrew the money as they pretend to be the owner of the bank account. According to NHK and Yomiuri, Ashinaga Ikuekai is the non-profit organization to support the orphan kids. They went to New York and then including the orphan from this earthquake and also 9/11 orphan. Joined together and called for the donation in the Times Square Garden on June 8th. So, yeah. And also, another sad news that many illegal loan providers are now lending the loan with extraordinary interest to the victim right now of North Japan. It's called Yami Kinyu in Japanese, but these are loan, just the company who just make the loan, not the bank. These loan financing company are usually run by Yakuza and Japanese mafia, and they lend out the money with extraordinary amount of the interest, and so people in the North Japan had to lend the money because they don't have money at all. Then these Japanese mafia took advantage of the situation, and they are lending them the money with the extraordinary amount of the interest right now. So we start getting that news according to Yomiuri.
We call them loan sharks.
Yeah, okay.
So. Loan sharks.
Loan sharks?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. See, I'm learning English every day. So, on June 10th,
Yami Kinyu is listed in Wikipedia under loan sharks.
Okay, cool. Oh no, it's not cool, but yeah. So on June 10th, the morning of June 10th, press conference of Chief Cabinet Secretary Edano-san, he apologized for the late slow reaction to the disaster, slow process of the Japanese government. And then he admit that the revive and reconstruction planning of the North Japan is too slow. They admit that. Edano-san admit that. And about by tomorrow, or I don't know when, finally Japanese parliament is going to finish up passing the Fukou Kihon Hōwan, which means the reconstruction basic bill, I don't know in English, but they are working to pass the fundamental bill to launch the ministry agency, the reconstruction agency, and then to speed up the process of the reconstruction. Inter-agency, like inter-government agency, inter-government agency to speed up the reconstruction effort. They're going to make new agency, because you know this disaster was so huge that Ministry of Agriculture, Ministry of Land, Ministry of Department has to kind of work closely together. So in order to do it, they should form the new agency. What's up?
Task force?
It's actually an agency.
Oh, well, then it's a new agency.
Yeah, new agency. Yeah, they are going to launch the new agency to consolidate from all the other agencies and ministry into one, put them all into one agency so that they can speed up the process.
Conglomerate.
Yeah. So the bill the Japanese parliament are discussing right now is try to pass that bill so that they can launch the reconstruction agency by tomorrow. So that's what they're doing. And according to the Hong Kong government, they lifted they lifted the restriction, travel advisory to Japan. And yeah, that's good. And many scientists, I'm going to skip it today because it's getting longer, but many scientists are coming up with, day after day, they're coming up with the new research result. For example, did I mention last week that there are some chances that we may still face the magnitude 7 class earthquake in North Japan? And then, they find out that tsunami was much more powerful than we thought by measuring the how tall it reached and everything, and how much debris, how much steel, how much building they were able to carry or destroyed and stuff. So Yomiuri, NHK, everywhere, it's reporting those new findings. So because, and again, it was June 11th. June 11th was the 3 month anniversary. So newspaper and TV station were covering the kind of the review of the last 3 months and interviewing the victim of the North Japan, which include, I also said that the victim, especially the people who couldn't find their family member's body yet, you know, they can apply the death certificate of their family members missing because it's only 3 months past. But the family member, remaining family member, are facing to make a hard decision right now, whether to accept that their missing family are already dead, or they want to try to find. They don't want to admit it until they find the body. But unless they turn in the death certificate application, they won't be able to receive the money, like health insurance and also government fund and stuff. So they do have to make a hard decision. According to Japan Meteorological Agency, from the June 14th to June 20th, we will have higher tide. So those who were sunk the below the ocean level in the North Japan, they have to watch out for the higher tide between June 14th and June 20th, according to a Japan Meteorological Agency. And on June 11th, as I said earlier, according to Yomiuri and all other many major media report that various organizations conducted a nationwide demonstration on June 11th. In Tokyo, about 24,000 people joined in the demonstration in Tokyo. Some sources said 5,000. So some said 1,000. So let's round them up. And I would say Tokyo demonstration was between 2,000 to 3,000 attendees, I think. We don't know, so we'll see. Then in Japanese media, they report about Germany's. They decided to stop all the nuclear power plant by 2022. And they also just reported about Italy's national poll about they voted against the nuclear power plant in Italy. So, and so that's
9-1, right?
Yeah, something like that. So those are the main stuff. Oh, now, okay. So now moving on to the Fukushima nuclear power plant update of this week. Yes, we have many, many bad news and many we should have news. According to NISA, Nuclear Industry Safety Agency, that they now think that within the 5 year of the earthquake, first nuclear reactors container were damaged within 5 hours of the earthquake. Earlier, according TEPCO thinks that first nuclear reactor container damaged 15 hours after the earthquake, or something like that. But Nuclear Industry Safety Agency think that first nuclear reactors container were damaged within 5 years of the earthquake. So we finding out all the numbers, and they are the situation of the Fukushima nuclear power plant was much worse than it was previously originally reported at the time I was reporting. So again, everyone, I'm gonna keep saying this to you guys. So I am reporting based on what the Japanese mainstream media and Japanese independent media say in Japanese. Because because we live, these news are coming up from Japan, so most of the latest, people keep sending me the news like from the what the foreign media are reporting, but those news are usually I hear them like a couple hours late or a month late. So okay, cats listen to this. Yeah, I know you. They report it already. So, but anyway, but what's my point is that I am, you know, I'm not the nuclear expert, so that's why I can only depend on these experts' report, press releases. So that's that's what I'm only doing. So you should believe in what the Japanese government say as much as
you believe in
your government. And you should believe in the mainstream Japanese mainstream media says as much as you believe in
your mainstream media
in your country says. And you know, so again, it is after all, you will, you know, is going to be the one who's going to who's going to decide if this is true information or not by studying it. But hopefully this information is going to help you to make a decision. So with me saying that usual disclaimer, and according to Yomiuri, and according to Ministry of Health, they have conducted a test of the breast milk from 8 prefectures. So they sampled 108 mothers' breast milk.
Sounds really awkward.
Yeah, and then they found a very small amount of the cesium from the 7 mothers from the Fukushima prefectures. The research was conducted in between May 18th and June 3rd in Fukushima, Miyagi, Yamagata, Ibaraki, Tochigi, Gunma, Chiba, Kochi. 8 prefectures and 108 mothers. As a result, from Soma, Fukushima, 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 and Iwaki, Fukushima, Nihonmatsu, Fukushima's 7 mothers from those cities, they found about 1.9 to 13.1 becquerel per kilogram of the cesium from the breast milk of those 7 mothers. According to a Japanese government, the drinking restriction of the radioactive contamination of the water to the babies are 200 becquerel per kilogram. So according to Japanese government health regulation standard, they said that 200, if the radioactive contamination is less than 200 becquerel per kilogram, they're supposed to be safe. Therefore, these are not at the health risk.
Not an immediate health risk, you should say, I think. Yeah. To use the oh-so-famous line that's been repeated so many times.
Well, that's what the news, and then that's what Japanese government says. So I'm just going to report that. And according to Fukushima cities, they are going to distribute decimeter to 34,000 decimeter.
Dosimeter.
Dosimeter, I'm sorry.
Sounds like a death meter.
Dosimeter. I don't know how to pronounce it well.
Dosimeter.
Mm. to 34,000 kids who goes to kindergarten, preschool, elementary, and middle schools in Fukushima Prefecture, Fukushima City, Fukushima Prefecture. So, yeah. So Fukushima City wants to make sure that kids of Fukushima are going to be closely monitored. And this is the report from Yomiuri and also many other organizations as well. So as you know, Itate Fukushima, they have, they are ordered to evacuate. And then concern is at those ranchers who bring up the cows and stuff. But according to Yomiuri, 70% of the rancher more likely to be go out of the business. So, oh, this is, I wanted to talk about this too. So, according to Yomiuri, on June 10th in the morning, a 60-year-old lady were stabbed by a 66-year-old guy who were the evacuees from Fukushima. So they don't know, they don't know the causes of why this 66-year-old guy stabbed a 60-year-old lady. But, you know, this is the this is the one of the few incidents that are reported. The trouble between the evacuees and the people, who's hosting them. Sounds familiar, Borden?
Yeah, we had a lot of, well, not between the hosts and the evacuees, but between the evacuees and the other evacuees, there was a lot of fighting.
Yeah, in Kazo, Saitama.
Yeah, there was also a lot of complaining from the evacuees to the people that came to see them. But never any fights between... No, maybe there was, actually. I just know that the police got called a lot of times.
Okay. So, we will start hearing these trouble. It's already stressful time, but this stressful life, you know, the situation is going to last longer. So, anyway, it's 9:30, Borden, so...
Oh, yeah, it is, isn't it?
Yeah. So, thank you very much, Borden.
No problem. I hope you don't get lonely.
No, I won't.
Last comment on the social stream was 55 minutes ago.
It's okay. I'm just keep reading the news anyway.
Well, all enjoy right. Making your archive.
I will. Okay, thank you, Borden.
No problem. Talk to you again soon. Bye.
Bye. All right. Then, next news is that the concern is the kids. I said according to Yomiuri, there are still 17,000 kids who are in 20 to 30 kilometer zone. So, as you know, that also freelance journalist, Japanese freelance journalist, warns as well. that the kids and the pregnant are the one who has to evacuate farther away as much as possible. So Yomiuri, but the Yomiuri says that about 17,000 kids came back to 20 to 30 kilometer zone area, which are appointed to be a evacuation preparation zone, because their parents' job situation, they had to come back to Fukushima. So Japanese TV news program is also kind of featuring these kids, that whether you parents has to kind of stay in Fukushima because they have a job, but they may send their kids to other area, or you know, but the kids get stressed because they're away from her parents. But you know, so should are they which one is the best choice for the parents? Send the kids away and kids being stressed being away, or having kids may be exposed to the radiation, they may have a risk of the health, but they have to live with, but it's better to live with the parents. We don't know, but anyway, 1700 kids are came back to 20 to 30 kilometer zone, evacuation preparation zone, to because of their parents' job situation. According to police department, about 695 thieves has been reported in and around Fukushima. At least 695 thieves has been reported, which is 40% more than last year for the 3 months since the March 11th, from March, April, and May. Within the 3 months, they had 695 thieves, which is 40% more from the previous year. And when and next next news, according to Yomiuri and NHK, the chairman of Nuclear Safety Commission, Madarame-san, appeared in front of the East Japan Disaster Reconstruction Committee meeting at the Japanese government parliament. And he admitted that this Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant incident could be considered as a man-made disaster. That Madarame chairman said that the Japanese government and TEPCO didn't pay attention to its safety planning. And Haruki Murakami, and the next news, Haruki Murakami, famous novelist, writer, he criticized in the Spain that this is the third nuclear disaster that Japan experienced since Hiroshima and Nagasaki. And as a victim of the nuclear bomb, we Japanese should have refused the nuclear energy, according to Haruki Murakami in From the Spain on June 9th. On June 8th, according to Yomiuri and TV Tokyo and NHK, first made in Japan robot is going to be used in the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant. Previously, all the robot has been used in the Fukushima Daiichi are not made in Japan, but made in USA or made in France and stuff. So this is like first robot that used, which are made in Japan. According to a according to TEPCO, they didn't disclose about 1,382 data from March 11th to 21st. And they're doing some investigation why they weren't able to release those data. 1,383 data of the radiation, everything that they failed to disclose. They are testing why. And according to NISA, Nuclear Industry Safety Agency, said that within the couple hours when the meltdown started happening, large amount of the hydrogen was generated. That's according to NISA's on June 8th. According to TEPCO, on June 8th, okay, sorry, I got unplugged my power, sorry guys. So according to according to TEPCO, on June 8th, they are planning to open the door of the turbine building in order to reduce the humidity of the second nuclear power plant, second nuclear reactor's turbine building. After they finish clean, they filter, they remove the radiation. So what happened is that the second nuclear reactor's turbine building is full of the humidity. So they need to remove the humidity, but they are having a hard time, so they are start thinking about opening up the door. So they are planning to do it towards the end of June to open up the door after they finish clean up the air. But that means that, you know, the maybe some amount of the radiation will be extracted more to the air. And then on June 9th, Japanese government are start considering to expand a evacuation area outside of the existing area, because some of the area in the Minamisoma or Date area, they found little bit higher radiation level. On June 9th, the Japanese government met up with the mayor of Minamisoma and Date and discuss with the further measurement of what to do. So next, TEPCO stock, I'm going to skip. However, the stock price of TEPCO are going up and down, and according to Yomiuri, looks like people are trying to make money playing the stock of the TEPCO. So today, according to NHK, and the price of stock of the TEPCO went up too much, like 20%, 30%. It's unbelievably like crazy, like the stuff that happening. People are having fun. Marbag, is there any word on the Steam event yesterday? No stream event yesterday. Annette, what's the music I have in the background? It's the music by Kevin McLeod that I found that I can use. And then next, IAEA news. I think you will be able to hear this news from the IAEA anyway. So IAEA start having a series of the meeting for a week or 2 weeks now, for almost. And IAEA now start advising a lot of stuff to the Japanese government that Steam event yesterday, I mean, it did happen last week. I mean, high amount of the steam was detected, but it was already in the update from the last week. So you could check that out from the last week. And then IAEA is going to monitor the ocean contamination level throughout the ocean in the Asia Pacific. That's really good. And IAEA said that they're going to monitor ocean. Where? Which went? What day? According to Yomiuri, on June 7th, IAEA said they're going to monitor the ocean contamination level across the Asia Pacific. That's good. And on June... And on June 10th by Yomiuri, IAEA said, criticized that NISA, Nuclear Industry Safety Agency, are not that independent. They need to be more independent to balance. Kind of big earthquake happening in Hokkaido right now, but it's seismic scale 4, so at 9:49 p.m. 2 minutes ago. Okay. Yeah. All right. Anyway, more coalition between IAEA and Japanese government are happening right now. So that's the news. And then, according to TEPCO, on June 8th, now I'm going into ocean contamination related news. That actually, at the Fukushima Daini nuclear power plant, this is not Daiichi, this is not Daiichi, this is Daini nuclear power plant. They have about 3,000 tons of low-level radioactive contaminated water at the underground of Fukushima Daini nuclear power plant. But they have to take care of those low level radioactive contaminated water. So according to TEPCO, they're going to filter those water, then they try to clean up those water, then they are planning to release those water to the ocean. So they have their radioactive contaminated water includes the cobalt 60 and cesium 137, 134. Cobalt 60 may be originated from the pipes, the rotten pipes of the Daini Fukushima nuclear power plant, and the cesium 137, 134 may be coming from the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant, which is kind of 10 kilometers north of the Fukushima Daini. And then, but according to TEPCO, they are preserving those the radioactive contaminated water inside of the tank of Fukushima Daini, and they are planning to release it after they filter those water. But they are planning to release some of the radioactive water onto the ocean after they clean up, according to TEPCO. And then, according to Yomiuri, this is the update of the NHK's news on June 8th. Ota Tokyo in the sewage processing facility, their radiation level was about 2.7 microsievert per hour. So this is the same amount that they detected in Fukushima, Japan. From this processing facility is called Nambu Sludge Plant. So this sludge plant is to collect the mud from the sewage processing facility and burn it and make it like ash, and then use it to landfill on the Tokyo Bay. So, sewage facility all in Tokyo, Fukushima, and Kanto area is the also the second concern now. I mean, not second. Why did I say second? But those are the concern, right? Those are the one of the concern now. So, those are the generic radioactive contaminated water story. Now we are going to have the news about strontium's story. According to TEPCO, on June 12th, from the underground water of first and second reactor, they found strontium 89 and strontium 90. According to NHK, so the amount of the strontium was they sampled on May 16th, and from that sample they found 1600 becquerel per kilogram of strontium 90 in the ocean of the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant. Near the second nuclear reactor's water entrance from the ocean, they found about 170 times as much legal limit of the strontium 90. Near the third nuclear power plant water entrance from the ocean, they have found 240 times as much legal limit. So from the sub-drain pit of the second nuclear reactor, they found 6,300 becquerel per kilogram of the strontium 90 on May 18th. So strontium. Okay. Then, on the June 8th, Minister of Education from the soil that they sample between the end of March to the beginning of the May, they found strontium 89 to 90. The maximum sample that they found was from May 6th, from Namie, Fukushima. They found 1,500 becquerel of the strontium 89 and 250 becquerel per kilogram of strontium 90 from Namie, Fukushima on May 6th, according to a Ministry of Education on June 8th. It took them quite a time to kind of find out, get the test result, I think. So, I'm going to skip this. So, I have the news about those oil filtering system, they just finished the test run today. They were having problem. They were originally thinking about starting this water filtering system on June 10th, but they are 5 days behind schedule because they had some trouble. So I have those news that how they have a trouble starting up these filtering system and stuff. But I'm going to skip those, like they found a hole and stuff too. And anyway, so this is the news from NHK on June 12th. Forced nuclear reactor spent fuel pool cooling system. They are having hard time to repair it because the planning system that they thought that they could use were broken. So they were planning to restore the cooling system of the forced nuclear reactor spent fuel pool by next month. However, because they found out the plumbing system is not functioning, so that the plan became indefinite. And then many. So many places, yeah, so forced nuclear reactors news, I have it too. Okay, then another news as well. So according to NISA, and Nuclear Safety Commission of Japan, on June 11th, they thought that they were releasing all the data of Speedy, the simulation already, like a simulation programming to release the data of how much radiation could be spread. But according to NISA and Nuclear Safety Commission of Japan, on June 11th, that they forgot to release 615 data that they were supposed to release. They said they are going to post it on their internet soon. Yeah. All right. So those are the news about could've, should've, and strontium news. Next, the last section of the news is about the safety of the TEPCO workers and TEPCO contracting workers on site. So, so far, on June 10th, according to TEPCO, 9 workers who went to the third nuclear reactor's turbine and third nuclear reactor's building those 9 workers were only supposed to be exposed to 9 millisievert per hour of the radiation for that the task, but they had to expose to 5.88 to 7.96 millisievert of the radiation above their scheduled exposure to the radiation. So they didn't pay attention to their radiation exposure level. And on June 13th, according to NHK, 1 workers of the TEPCO who is in 60s. He was supposed to wear a mask and he was supposed to install the filter onto the mask. But the contracting workers of the TEPCO, he forgot to install the filter onto the mask. According to him, according to TEPCO, because he didn't wear the mask, he was supposed to be exposed to 20 microsievert of the red 0.002 millisievert of the radiation. But you know, the safety standard of the TEPCO worker on site of the Fukushima Daiichi is not really fully engaged. So the you know, according to NHK, so far 3,726 TEPCO workers or TEPCO contracting workers came to work at the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant. Then out of those 4,000 workers, 2,367 workers have been tested for the radiation. Then six workers from those 2,376 workers, they were exposed to in between 264.7 millisievert to 497.6 millisievert of the radiation, which is over the legal limit, legal allowance of the radiation exposure, which is 250 millisievert, which Japanese government raised from 100 millisievert. So according to NHK, especially at the beginning of this incident, many TEPCO worker didn't wear the mask, didn't really pay attention to the safety. Some people even ate something by removing the mask on site of the Fukushima nuclear power plant after the incident happened. So they have detected some internal radiation exposure too. So TEPCO work, you know, Ministry of Health is now conducting the investigation of how TEPCO took care of the safety of the TEPCO workers and TEPCO contracting workers. And this is getting hotter, it's getting warmer. According to TEPCO, they said that they are going to install the place, air-conditioned place, for the worker to be able to take a rest. According to TEPCO, workers during the shift, TEPCO workers are like wear those protective suits with mask, and if they're outside of the Fukushima nuclear power plant, they cannot remove the mask, so they won't be able to even drink water. So because of that, about 11 TEPCO workers or TEPCO contracting worker were sent to the hospitals by June 8th because of the heat stroke or dehydration. So, according to TEPCO, they built the temporary housing with air filtering place or rest area where TEPCO worker can go in and to drink water and stuff. So, TEPCO workers now has to fight with the heat and then health of the TEPCO workers on site. So one worker, so according to TEPCO, on June 10th, one 40-year-old TEPCO contracting workers became unconscious in the morning, and he was sent to the hospital in Iwaki, Fukushima by doctor helicopter in the morning of June 10th. So, yeah. Yeah, so that's pretty much it for today. And then today, according to today, the latest news of today. According to the latest news of today, they are trying to set a new safety standard of the for the workers to protect the health. And according to Ministry of Health, Labor and Welfare, if the worker is suspected to be exposed to more than 100 millisievert of the radiation internally, Health Ministry of Health demands TEPCO not to send them to work for the safety. All right, that's pretty much the this week's update. So it's 2 hour long update. So yeah. Hey Harry Kobe. Hey Eyes, Harry Kobe here. I now see the social timeline. Sorry about that. We had so much news today. And 615 data to be released. Yes. What's 615 data? Which one was it? Yeah. Hey, Domian. So these are the bad news, but not urgent news. The ocean contamination, now they detect strontium. More strontium were found on site of the Fukushima nuclear power plant. Then, oceans, they found the strontium on the ocean near, on site, within the site of the Fukushima nuclear power plant. So that, it's going to be leaked a little bit to the outside of the ocean. And then safety of the kids are the concern too. And then anti-nuclear demonstration was happened, organized last end of the last anti-nuclear demonstration was organized last Saturday, but it was complete failure in Japan. Not so many Japanese are paying attention to the anti-nuclear act because they don't want to be responsible of what they're saying. Yeah, although many people are against or support the nuclear power plant, but nobody wants to speak out because that's a Japanese culture. The virtue is to be quiet and silent. And so, okay, everything else. Then the concern is now getting to the mental state of the victim of the North Japan and stuff too. So that's pretty much the quick overview of the, this week's a weekly update of the Japan from Yokai Jimiya, Japan. All right. Hey Ben in Hawaii. Hey Ben, Lingley. You following me? Thank you very much. Hey Maria. Okay, Maria. Hey Sarah Fine. Sarah Fine. Hey to Netherlands. So okay. Do you guys have any other question of this week's update from the social timeline? Otherwise, I'm going to conclude this week's weekly update of the YokosoNews 311 update. Everyone, this is Katz from YokosoNews, YokosoNews.com. YokosoNews is the online website to introduce Japan in English so that you can understand Japan more. If you haven't, you should check the archive of Dr. Shinsaku livecast from 2 days ago. That's available on YokosoNews, Maria on the social timeline. Maria, you heard about the Filipina a while ago, so yeah, I know. The husband husband end up committing suicide, and who owns the farm, who owns the animal farm with the cow, and he was just taking care alone. He sent his Filipina wife and kids back to Philippines, and he got depressed and he committed suicide. So that was the news. Lack of training by TEPCO to train worker to install breathing filter or worker error. I don't know from that, from the news source that I got from. So I'm going to refrain the comment of further comment, Harry Colbert. But I only know the fact that these TEPCO worker forgot to install the breathing filter. Then that worker might be internally exposed to the radiation more than Ministry of Health is warning. You know, really want to make sure TEPCO is enforcing these TEPCO workers and contracting worker to make sure their health. So that's it. So, you know, YokosoNews is, you know, usually bring in the entertainment information, but because, you know, YokosoNews, one of the core mission of YokosoNews is to provide the information during the disaster and the disaster prevention. It was already the core mission of the YokosoNews since the launch of the YokosoNews. So, since the March 11th tsunami, earthquake, and Fukushima nuclear incident, I've been, you know, dedicated a part of the YokosoNews to provide the information, latest information of the disaster and Fukushima nuclear power plant incident. I'm dedicating to this broadcast to mainly two kinds of people. You know, I originally dedicate this broadcast to the people who live in Japan and who don't really speak English. because most of the in-depth detailed news about these are only provided in Japanese. So I really want to help you guys to understand how what Japanese people are talking about. Then second kind of people I like this broadcast dedicated to is the people who have a direct relationship to Japan. For example, you have family member, friends or loved one in Japan, so that you'll be informed. But also I know that there's a people all over the world who wants to still know what's going on in Japan too, because you know stuff. So I'm here to those of you who wants to know and stuff. And I strongly believe that, you know, this knowledge and experience that we have, it's going to be beneficial for the future generation. So, because I learned it from 1995, I've felt great Hanshin earthquake, and I saw 6,000 people die in great Hanshin earthquake, and it happened out of nowhere again 16 years ago, and then Annette, you wrote in Swedish. Okay, bye bye, Annette. So 15 years ago we didn't think that earthquake happened, but it did happen out of nowhere. So I knew that this kind of disaster will happen out of nowhere. So we always kind of have to prepare, like a tornado in the United States happened, like, you know, last month and stuff too. So by reporting this information, although many people lost the focus again, but again, you know, last couple days the Christchurch had another big earthquake too. But Japan is the country where we face many disaster, typhoon, heavy rain, and then snowing part of the area, and then earthquake and volcanic activity. However, that is why we are receiving the benefit of having the great nature too. That's why we are able to enjoy the hot spring. So we have to learn to live. Everywhere in the world we have the natural disaster, so we kind of have to learn to live with it. So by knowing this knowledge for the future, we will be able to get ready for it. In fact, on the March 11th I knew that from our past experience, I knew that phone line will be jammed, but internet won't be. So I was able to, I know that I could contact with my friends in Tokyo to report me what's going on, because internet was built more securely than the telephone line. I was still shocked on the time of the disaster, March 11th and stuff, but I knew what to act. I knew what to say exactly, because I was getting ready to report March 11th earthquake. I wasn't fully ready, but you know, but I was preparing to report the disaster. So by preserving this, I'm sure not so many people gonna watch this show these days, but by this preserving this knowledge, hopefully we can be better prepared for the future. So that is the purpose of this 311 disaster update. I'm committed to continue this disaster update at least for a year until March 11th, 2012 on a regular basis. I'm doing it weekly. Maybe I will switch back to monthly or something, but we'll see. So anyway, this has been the weekly update of the 311 disaster update. Today is the 40th time of the 311 disaster update. It has been long or short, but so I guess you guys don't have any question then on the social timeline. So please, if you haven't done it yet, please like us at YokosoNews on Facebook, or please follow us at YokosoNews on Twitter. You are welcome to post a comment and any input for the Twitter or your Twitter or Facebook at YokosoNews. Or if you are shy to make a public comment, you are welcome to come to YokosoNews.com and click contact hyperlink on the top right of the page, and you can write me an email. Squeal key voice. Okay. No problem, and you're welcome. Damien. So, Damien, no, I mean, just one whole year. No. The 1995 Great Hanshin Kobe earthquake. It's less scale though, but huge earthquake happened 16 years ago too. So I'm also committed to report. I was planning to make a comprehensive report of the Great Kobe earthquake 16 years ago. So, you know, so this is the long term knowledge, because it's going to take years to be rebuild. So, so I know that I will have to keep reporting this for years now. So, all right, and I don't know how to pronounce, but yes, you're welcome. All right, so okay, so if you guys don't have any idea, if you guys don't have any other information, I will going to conclude this week's update. Okay, so thank you very much everyone for watching Yokoso News weekly update of the 311, and I am planning to come back next Tuesday night as well. Tuesday night. Tuesday night is what day is it? 21st? Yeah, 21st. All right. Okay. Yeah, I kind of want to plan for more regular update, but I'm working on one project, so I just going to have to do some stuff. All right. So next week I'll come back for on June 21st in next live cast. It's going to be in 7 days. And but sometime, you know, I may do some update in the mid, and of course if there is emergency I will come back live. So Sarafine, you're welcome. Harry Kobir, you're welcome. Okay. So alright. So I guess I'm going to sign off tonight. Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to follow us at YokosoNews on Twitter, or don't forget to like us at YokosoNews on Facebook. It has been the weekly live cast of the disaster update. This is Kat from YokosoNews.com. All right. Good night. Bye-bye. Thank you.